door is sealed shut. I know what I have to do. Skyview Temple. Master, I have bad news. The auras of many creatures reverberate throughout this temple. As a result, I can't isolate Zelda's aura. You will not be able to track her here. Given the situation, I suggest you look around to see where we should move next. Bit redundant to have a save thing immediately in the temple where there's a save thing directly outside of it, but okay. Descended from the sky, lend your ear to the wise voice of the servants who brought you to the firm soil. Interesting message. This is some pretty good music though. I like it a lot. It really matches the mood pretty well, and it doesn't necessarily sound like video game music. It's very cinematic, I'd say. Barred door. spider. That's a gold tool. Ugh. Two doors lead to rooms left and right, but they will only open when the gemstones are struck. One is above, one below. Alright. I never told you that I hate spiders. You got a monster claw. This extremely sharp claw looks painful to even touch. I guess below doesn't mean down here, does it? Well, okay, fair enough. Maybe it doesn't mean in this room. It's been a while, so I kind of forgot some of the things, but I think I vaguely remember there being some switches down here. Maybe. That seems to have been the solution. You got another green guy. Ow! Gaze upon your map until your eye finds the X, for it is here that you must strike a glittering gemstone to reveal a path. You shall find a temple map in the room, in a room with two such gemstones. Found a map. That tablet very easily could have just said, "You'll find a map in the next room." Ah. It also reveals the location of treasure chests, so be sure to take a look. Master, I have information for you. You have obtained a map of this area. You can view it by pressing the plus.
The position of doors and their locks, as well as the position of and status of treasure chests,
can be confirmed on the map with marks such as X. However, be aware that you will be unable to use beacons here. Alright. So, let's see what we can do now. I'm back in the center. Ow! Okay, there goes my potion. He's still down here? Well, not anymore. Okay, well, I just went in a circle. Ah, yes, because it's the other way I meant to go. That makes sense. So maybe, maybe there's another way to get over there. So theoretically, I should be able to get over there from that vine over there, but how do I get over to that vine is the question. I guess I could use that, maybe? Ah, wait a minute.
Dad!
There we go. Okay.
Dad!
No, it's not gonna work. Alright, now we're going places. Sorry that took so long.
Well, then again for you.
I'm sure I fast-forwarded that, so I doubt it actually took as long as it took for me to figure out. Water not raised in here? Okay then. It might help if I looked at my map a bit more often, but here we go. I still can't get over there without. But I can start to do other things, I believe.
Yep.
Ah, yes, I can get up there. Here we are. Don't look at me.
Ha! 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 Ha
Here we go. And I finally got a key. You got a small key. This will open a locked door. You can only use it in this area. Now we can go through that door. Here we go. There we go. That'll do it. Huck. That wasn't too bad. I was certainly expecting a lot worse. And we get a new treasure. You got the beetle. The unexplained power contained within this insect-shaped item allows you to control it as it flies through the air. Unexplained power is called electricity. Nice. You have acquired a new item now, so this object's insect-like profile and wings indicate it can fly. Tilt the Wii remote to remotely pilot the device. The sharp structure on the front of the device can sever threads and deliver a blow to smaller objects. This will be useful. I mean, obviously. In fact, use number one. I guess we're going this way. Oops. There we go. That took way too long. Was that not the right one? Well, no wonder I was struggling with it. Where's the correct one? Is it in there? It's in there, isn't it? Well, that explains why it was a challenge. No, it's not in here. This is a dead end. Here we go. That was embarrassing. But hey, I got a heart piece out of it. I don't have a key. Where am I supposed to get a key? There was... Maybe here. There we go. So that I could get up there? The goddess loves her sliding block puzzles. Yes. Alright, here we go. And now, because I've done the water, I can get back up here, crawl through, and get back to the right area. Happening a lot. Oh, here we go. Oh. Well, that wasn't hard at all. I forget what those things are called. I mean, I guess I could ask Fi, but. I believe in you. Yeah, so that's right. Just one foot in front of the other. And whoops. Okay. I kind of need some stuff here. Finally. Okay, here we go. A 7 out of 10. It needs more seats. Actually, no, I don't really like this one very much, this dungeon. I definitely prefer other ones to this one. Yes, that is a statement I'm going to make. Shut up, fine. I don't want to hear what you have to say because I already know it. Slowly but surely, I'm getting back into the swing of things. No pun intended. I didn't even think about what I was about to do while I was saying that. I'm so sorry. No! Well, okay, I'm sure there is a simple solution to this. Why? Okay. I can do this. Just gotta breathe and take it slow. Maybe I need to be lower. Because clearly I'm not being sent far enough. Okay. Yeah, because if that wasn't far enough, then I was about to be real upset. And we finally got the boss key. This dungeon has gone on far longer, at least for me, than I was intending it to. Since I don't know exactly what I've done in editing to make it shorter, I don't know how much of an impact that's had on the length of this video, but hopefully it's not too long. This will be kind of like my test to see if I should do the areas and the level, or and the dungeons in one episode, or if I should split them up more. Here we go. I'll save real quick. I do like the boss of this level, though. I don't need your help, Fi. Bird. That's interesting. And in we go. Look who it is. I thought that tornado I stirred up would have tossed and torn you apart. Yet here you are, not in pieces. Not that your life or death has any consequence. It's just the girl that matters now. And I can sense her here, just beyond this door. Yes, we plucked Her Majesty from her perch in the clouds, and now she's ours. Oh, but listen to me. I'm being positively uncivil. Allow me to introduce myself. I am the Demon Lord who presides over this land you look down upon. This world you call the surface, you may call me Girahim. In truth, I very much prefer to be indulged by my full title, Lord Girahim. But I'm not fussy. Well, that made Link angry. And I love how Link just decides this guy must be evil. Did you really just draw your sword? Foolish boy. By all rights, the girl should have fallen to our hands already. She was nearly ours when that loathsome servant of the goddess snatched her away. Do you have any idea how that made me feel inside? Furious! Outraged! Sick with anger! This turn of events has left me with a strong appetite for bloodshed. Still, it hardly seems fair, being of my position, to take out all my anger on you. Which is why I promise up front not to murder you. No, I'll just beat you within an inch of your life. All right, here we go. Quite the sword you have here. But as long as you telegraph your attacks like a novice, like the novice you are, you'll never land a blow. Integrity of your shield. Yes, I know. Huh? go.
See?
Well, you put up more of a fight than I would have thought possible out of such a soft boy. But don't clap for yourself just yet. That sword of yours is the only reason you still live. I fear I've spent far too long teasing and toying with you. The girl's presence is all but faded from this place, which means there's no reason to linger here. Goodbye, Skychild. Run and play this time. Get in my way again, though, and you're dead. Looks like we did it. You got a heart container. Your life increased by one and is now fully replenished. Master, I have a message written in the language of the gods of old. Allow me to translate for you. From the edges of time I guide you, the one chosen to carry out the goddess's mission. The spirit maiden who descended from the clouds must travel to two sacred places to purify her body. You stand in one of these places, Skyview Spring. The other is known as the Earth Spring. The second spring is hidden away, deep within the scorched earth of Elden. The spirit maiden, ever mindful of the heavy task entrusted to her, has set out for the second sacred place. Got the ruby tablet. The weathered surface of this heavy stone tablet feels old. Master, as I just translated, it would appear that Zelda purified herself in the waters of this spring. I calculated a 97% chance that she has already set out for Elden, where another great spring exists. However, it is not clear what method of travel Zelda used to move from here to her next destination. My analysis suggests she should take the tablet to the altar in Skyloft. Doing so will likely open a new column of light on the surface, allowing you to descend to another area and continue your search for Zelda. The bird statue that transports you back to the sky should be in the forest you previously passed through. Alright. And that is where I have to end this episode. So thank you for watching. If you like this video, feel free to give it a like. Otherwise, it just takes one click to subscribe. This is Sheenferno, signing off.
that